Hello to all the participants. I am Dr. Achala Munigal, working as Assistant Professor in Library and Information Science and Assistant Librarian in University College of Science, Osmania University, which is in Hyderabad in Telangana state. Welcome to the first video of Style Manuals, where I will be covering the history about style sheets in the first module. Let us start the first week module by staying connected and finish the module of the style manual successfully. I wish you all the best. Do you know how many citation styles are there? The Times Higher Education reports on its website that there are more than 3,000 ways to cite source material. Is providing citations a new phenomenon, or did it exist earlier too? Pre-Socratic work has not survived and are lost to us, so we cannot substantiate if references were provided or not. Our limited knowledge of these earlier works only exists through references provided by later authors who have recorded them in their works. For example, our knowledge of Thales of Miletus, a Greek philosopher who lived between 624 to 546 BC, who was also considered as one of the seven sages of Greece, comes largely from the works of Aristotle, who lived many centuries after Thales. This is because of references made by Aristotle on Thales of Miletus in his own work. There were many attempts made by many to record and reference earlier works. Few are listed below. Augustus Emanuel Becker, a philologist, introduced Becker pagination, or the Berlin numbering. Becker was the editor of 1831 Berlin edition, hence it is known as Becker pagination after its editor, and also called as Berlin numbering after the location of the publisher, Prussian Academy of Sciences, which was in Berlin. Jonas Serrans was a French historian who translated a three-volume 1578 edition of Plato's works, which was published by printer Henricus Stephanus, which followed a certain kind of pagination rules set by Stephanus, hence it's called Stephanus pagination. Hermann Alexander Diels, a German classical scholar, and Walther Kranz, a German classical philologist, together collected various quotations and paraphrases of pre-Socratic philosophers in their book, Die Fragmente der Vorostokratiker, the fragments of the pre-Socrates, and published it in 1903, which used a particular way of referencing the material, which became popular as Diels-Kranz numbering. More attempts were made and recorded in the modern day. Few modern endeavors are discussed here. Currently, most of the established journal and book publishers have either adopted existing standardized style sheets or have introduced an in-house standard or variation of existing style sheet to be followed by authors. For example, Emeril follows different style sheets for books and journals. Emeril Publishing was founded in 1967 and has more than 300 journals and 2,500 books in its portfolio. It follows the APA 6th edition for books and Harvard referencing for journals. Elsevier provided a reference simplification, as majority of journals it publishes follow one of the 10 standard referencing styles, and 200 plus journals use unique non-standard reference styles. So in 2013, Elsevier switched to a standard 6 reference styles, including numbered, Harvard, Vancouver numbered, Vancouver name date, American Psychological Association, and American Medical Association. One must also understand that few journals like to follow their own citation style, like the Annals of Library and Information Studies, which has given Niskayer style guide format of citation style for authors to follow. A few others adapt one of the standardized citation style, like British Medical Journal, which follows Vancouver style. E.C. Friedberg published an article in Nature calling for publishers and editors to agree on single standard reference format, but there was no support from other publishers and editors. ISO 2 issued guidelines like ISO 690:2010, which is an ISO standard that provides guidelines for bibliographic referencing and citations to information sources, but does not prescribe a particular style of reference or citation. Various others proposed having standard basic information like author ID, publication ID, object identifier, publisher identifier, date of publication or access, and specific location such as page number if necessary, but even this was not accepted. Word also provides an easy way to add citation in various formats including APA, Chicago style, IEEE, ISO 690 and MLA, which is integrated into its software. Even after so many efforts were made to standardize referencing and citation style sheets, they are no major supporters, as each publisher follows its own policy, while various disciplines in the university system across the world follow standardized style sheets from associations. In India, most departments set and follow their own standards or follow style their predecessors had adopted. Very few departments are following international standardized style sheets. Most universities in India, including University of Delhi, Osmania University, etc., do not have research manuals displayed on their website where style sheets are given or citation styles to be followed in any discipline are mentioned. JNU published a research manual in 2006, which is shared online for all researchers and their supervisors to refer in case of any clarification or doubts. Total number of universities in the country as on 20th December 2018 is 892, including 394 state universities, 125 deemed to be universities, 48 central universities, and 325 private universities. In an ideal situation, every university in India should follow a specific standardized citation style for a given discipline, so it is easier for faculty to guide students regarding which style is to be followed, and also how citation will help avoid plagiarism accusations. Probably, if UGC standardizes citation styles to be followed for each discipline, then universities may adopt them across all of India for master's and MPhil dissertations and PhD theses. Elsevier reports that authors spend on an average 3.2 hours per paper for compiling with reference-related instructions provided by journal publishers, hoping following our modules on style sheets, you will be able to cut down the time. We have covered the history about style sheets in this module, hoping you are looking forward for the next module. In the next module, I will be explaining usage of various terminology used while doing research and also various types of citation systems. Thank you for staying connected.